So yeah, questioning first, do we really need high intensity training? So if you just go back to what the Danish team with Bangsbo have been publishing for more than 10 years, the answer is always straight and linear. The answer is yes. Why yes? Because you just look at performance on the yo-yo intermittent level 2, which is a kind of a measure of high intensity performance. It's clearly, you have a clear trend that the fact that the elite and the better player are fitter than the less skilled or the recreational players. So the response will be yes. I'm just a bit worried that about this response, which is a little bit too simple probably. And I just wanted to take you to an example of one player, but I would have much more, but this particular player who was at this time one of the best handball player in the world. So he was definitely in the top five player at this time in this game. And I just wanted to take you with me about his testing results. So this pointer doesn't work. So just follow the arrow of my computer. So this player Ekel is the black dot, and it's always compared with the team that's the green triangle, and then the red dot, which is the best player of the team. So as you can see briefly, he's definitely not bigger, taller than the team. He's actually much fatter than the rest of the team. Thank you. He's also okay. Sorry. Looking at speed of shooting speed, he's definitely not the best. That's his conditioning level. He's within the team, but that's not amazingly better. And if you look at his sprinting time, he's within the range, 30 meter time within the range, and counter movement jump, he just doesn't jump. So, but yeah, that's the reality. So, you know, like at this time, I was just like completely new in this industry, let's say, and I just thought that I had to have all my players being faster, stronger, and whatever, and we just having the chance to work with him and with the guys, we just have to reconsider a little bit what we are really looking for, because in the end, this guy was the best player, one of the best players in the world, with very average physical quality. So shall we really make everything possible to improve physical quality? Of course, you will always say, who has the better, let's say, but it's maybe not compulsory. I'm just going to finish my argument with a funny video from Abrainovic, where is the fitness in this sequence? Okay, I think yeah, you got the idea.